सुप्रभात माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे दिस इज माय थर्ड लेक्चर ऑन चैप्टर नंबर 2 बायोलॉजिकल क्लासिफिकेशन। सो इन द लास्ट लेक्चर्स वी हैव स्टडीड किंगडम मोनेरा एंड किंगडम प्रोटिस्टा इन डिटेल। इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी किंगडम फंगाई और यू कैन ऑल्सो कॉल इट एज किंगडम माइकोटा इन डिटेल। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ टुडेज लेक्चर किंगडम फंगाई। इट इज अ यूनिक किंगडम ऑफ हीटरोट्रॉपिक ऑर्गेनिजम्स। सो व्हाट डू मीन बाय हीटरोट्रॉपिक ऑर्गेनिजम्स? द ऑर्गेनिजम्स विच आर डिपेंडिंग ऑन द अदर ऑर्गेनिजम्स फॉर देयर फूड पर्पज। क्लियर? फंगाई और कॉस्मोपॉलिटन मीन्स वॉट? दे ऑकर इन एयर, वॉटर, सॉइल एंड ऑन एनिमल्स एंड प्लांट्स। Means everywhere, cosmopolitan means they are present everywhere, in the water, in the air, in the soil, in the plants or in the animals. So everywhere these are present. So those are called as cosmopolitan. Fungi prefer to grow in warm and humid places, wherever the temperature is more, wherever some moisture is there, water is there. Humid means some moisture will be there. In such places, the fungi will grow very fast. For example, bread mold or orange rots, mushrooms, these are the examples. So here you can see the bread mold. If you keep the bread for more than 3 to 4 days, then you will find the black spots on that. So here you can see these are the bread mold. So this is nothing but the fungus. Then the mushroom, whatever the mushroom you see, so those are also the fungi, white color. Then on the leaves of the plants, you can see the powder-like structure. So those are nothing but the fungi or the fungus. Okay. Then, some fungi are the source of antibiotics. Some are used to prepare the antibiotics. For example, the penicillium. So here you can see this is the penicillium. These are used to produce the antibiotic in the medicine, for the medicine purpose. Okay. Some unicellular fungi, for example, yeast. Here you can see this is the yeast. These are used to make the bread and beer in the bakery products for making the bread. Here this yeast is used. Then here you can see the structure of yeast. Can you see this rounded structures? Those are nothing but the yeast. It is a type of fungi. Other fungi cause diseases in plants and animals. So some fungi are there which cause the diseases to the plants as well as the animals. For example, the wheat rust causing Puccinia. Puccinia, this is the name of the fungi which cause the wheat rust on the leaves of the wheat. Wheat means gahu. On the leaves of the wheat, backside of the leaves, you will find the powdery structure. So here you can see the rounded body, small. Those are nothing but the Puccinia. This is a type of fungi. So it causes the rust. Rust means guns lagla sarka. So it causes the rust on the leaves. So the photosynthesis will be decreased. Ultimately the yield or the product will come less. So Puccinia, this is a type of fungi which causes the wheat rust. Okay, so these are disease causing fungi. Some are useful also. Some are useful also in producing the antibiotics. Used to make the breads or the bakery products, and some are causing the diseases. Except the yeast. If you see the last slide, here you can see the structure of the yeast, how it is rounded structure. Okay, so except this yeast, the all fungi are filamentous. You can see, can you see here the filament like structure? All the fungi are having the thread-like structure, filament-like structure, filamentous. Their bodies consist of long, slender, thread-like structure. So this long, slender, thread-like structure, it is called as the hyphae or hypha, single hypha or plural, singular word hypha. If you plural, then it is hyphae. The network of hyphae is known as mycelium. So one, this is called as the hypha, and the network, it is called as the mycelium. Remember these terms, hyphae, and the network of hyphae is called as the mycelium. Okay. Some hyphae are continuous ट्यूब्स फिल्ड विथ मल्टी न्यूक्लिएटेड साइटोप्लाज्म. सो सम हाइफे यू विल फाइंड दे अपीयर कंटिन्यूस ट्यूब लाइक स्ट्रक्चर. हियर यू कैन सी हियर नो सेप्टा और नो सेगमेंटेशन इज देयर. ट्यूब लाइक स्ट्रक्चर इज देयर. सो द ट्यूब लाइक स्ट्रक्चर इज देयर. सो दे आर मल्टी न्यूक्लिएटेड. मेनी न्यूक्लियसिस आर प्रेजेंट. यू कैन सी हियर दिस इज ट्यूब लाइक स्ट्रक्चर एंड मेनी न्यूक्लियसिस आर प्रेजेंट. सो दीज आर कॉल्ड एज सीनोसाइटिक हाइफे. हियर यू कैन सी दिस इज सीनोसाइटिक हाइफे. सो वॉट इज सीनोसाइटिक हाइफे? हाइफे इन हाइफे विच आर ट्यूब लाइक एंड फील्ड विथ मल्टी न्यूक्लिएटेड साइटोप्लाज्म. दे आर फील्ड विथ साइटोप्लाज्म एंड इन दैट साइटोप्लाज्म यू विल फाइंड द मेनी न्यूक्लियसिस. हियर यू कैन सी इन दिस डायग्राम. सो इट इज कॉल्ड एज सीनोसाइटिक हाइफे. Others have septae or cross walls in hypha. So here you can see this is the septate hypha. Here you can see the septa is there or the wall is there and each is having the single nucleus. So this is called as the septate hypha. This is called as septate hypha. This is sinusitic hypha and this is septate hypha. Then the fungal cell wall. Okay. So this is covered by the cell wall. Whatever this cell wall is there, the cell wall of this fungus is made up of chitin and polysaccharide. Remember this term. The wall of the fungi is made up of chitin and polysaccharides. Clear? So this is the structure of fungi. Then most fungi are saprophytes. So what do you mean by saprophytes? Absorb organic soluble matter from the dead substrate. Dead substrate. The fungus which are absorbing, saprophytic means they are taking their food. Food is nothing but the organic soluble matter. So that food from where they are taking? From the dead substrate, the dead animals or the dead plants. From that they are absorbing their food. They are called as the saprophytes. So most of the fungi are saprophytes because they are not having the green color pigment in them. So these are depending on the other organism. So saprophytes means they are taking their food from the dead substrate, dead plants or dead animals. Clear? Then some are parasites. Parasites means what? They are living on the other plants or other animals and living animals and taking their nutrition from them. Okay. Then some live as symbionts. So this is important one. Some live as the symbionts. Now symbionts means what? They are living in association with each other. For example, in association with algae as lichen. The fungi, association of fungi and the algae. Association of fungi and algae, it is called as the lichen. This you will study in detail in the next lecture. Okay. So here the fungi and the algae, they are living together. So how symbiont means what? Both are getting the benefits. Fungi are getting their food from the algae. Algae, they will prepare their own food. We know algae, they are having the green color pigment. So they prepare their own food. So algae will give the food material to the fungi. And instead of that fungi, what it will do? It will absorb the water and give it to the algae for preparation of the food material. So both are getting benefit. So what it is called as symbiont. Okay, so the association of the fungi and the algae is called as what? Lichen. Then one more association you will find with roots of higher plants as mycorrhiza. So here you can see this is mycorrhiza with the roots of the higher plants. So what is this white color it is there? It is the fungi and these are the roots. So this root of the higher plants and this fungi, they are living in association. So both are getting the benefit. The fungi are absorbing the nutrients or the other minerals from the soil and they are giving it to the roots. And roots, what they are giving? They are giving the food material to them, stored food material. So both are getting the benefit. So this is called as symbionts. So here this is the mycorrhiza, higher plants. Now the reproduction of the fungi, reproduction in the fungi. So reproduction, it occurs by vegetative propagation, asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. So vegetative reproduction, it occurs by three means: fragmentation, fission and budding. then asexual and sexual type. So vegetative propagation, three types are there: fragmentation, fission and budding. So first one, that is fragmentation. Fragmentation means what? Suppose one organism is there, it may be plant or it may be animal, okay? Then when you cut that organism into the fragments, into small pieces, for example, leaf is there, a long leaf, and if you cut that leaf into the 4 to 5 pieces, and if you grow that each part into the soil, each will develop into the new plant. Same in case of the animals. If you cut the animal, for example, the planaria, if you cut it into the pieces, they will, each part of that animal, each part of that will develop into the new animal, which is similar to the parent. So that is called as a fragmentation. Then comes the fission. Fission means what? It is the division. Division of the cell. So division of the cell into two cells. So both the cells will develop into the new organism. That is called as the fission. Fission means the breaking down. Then budding. Budding, it is the outgrowth. Suppose one straight plant is there, and at the particular point, the more cell division will be occurring, and from that a bud-like structure is coming. And outgrowth, a small outgrowth will be coming out, and that outgrowth will develop into the, if you cut that out part and put it into the soil, it will develop into the new plant. Or for example, in the yeast, the small rounded bodies, that is nothing but the bud. So it is the outgrowth of the organism, that is the budding. So these all comes under the vegetative propagation: fragmentation, fission and budding. Clear? Now, asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. So first, asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction, it occurs by spores, by formation of the spores. So here you can see the formation of the spores. Spores are also, formation of the spores, different types of spores are there. It is called as conidia or sporangiospores or zoospores. So here in this diagram you can see the conidia are there, spores. So at the tip of this fungi, you will find the small rounded bodies. These are nothing but the spores. So spores are released, and whenever the spores, they will get the favorable condition, means little bit of water and appropriate temperature, then they will germinate. So here you can see the spores are germinated, and this has developed into the hyphae. So this hyphae will start growing, and they form the what? Colony of hyphae is called as the mycelium. So long hyphae will be produced, and mycelium, and finally the organism, that is fungi, is formed. So this is asexual reproduction by conidia or by spores. Conidia is nothing but the spore. Asexual reproduction. Next is the sexual reproduction. So sexual reproduction occurs by the oospores, ascospores and basidiospores. They are produced in distinct structures called as fruiting bodies. So in the fruiting body, so this is the agaricus or the mushroom. In this fruiting body, the spores are produced: oospores, ascospores and basidiospores. So here basidiospores are produced. So these spores, sexual reproduction, how it takes place, we'll study in detail in the next slide. Okay, so the spores, whatever are produced, they will fuse together, and then the diploid cells are produced, and then they will germinate, and they produce the mycelia, and mycelia it produce the primordia, means the premature agaricus or premature mushroom, and then it will develop into the mature mushroom and produces the fruiting body. Then fruiting body again produces the spores. So this life cycle will be continued. So what are the stages of sexual reproduction, we will study in detail now. So understood here, asexual reproduction, sexual reproduction, we will study now. So sexual cycle or sexual reproduction, it involves three steps. The first one, plasmogamy. Second one, karyogamy. And third one, meiosis. So what are these steps in detail, that we'll see now. Plasmogamy, it is nothing but, plasmogamy is nothing but the fusion of protoplasm between two motile or non-motile gametes. So just remember, fusion of protoplasm. Okay, fusion of protoplasm between two gametes. So these gametes, they may be motile or they may be non-motile. Motile means what? They are moving. They have the flagella or cilia and they are moving. And non-motile means they are not moving. Okay, so fusion of protoplasm between two gametes, that is called as the plasmogamy. So here you can see plasmogamy. So after plasmogamy, how it occurs? You can see the two gametes, I said, N plus 1, N plus N. So one gamete is having N set of chromosome, another gamete is having another N set of chromosome. So N plus N, when it fuses together, that is plasmogamy. So you know the gamete, it is having the cytoplasm will be there, and in the cytoplasm one nucleus will be there. So first the fusion of what will occur? Protoplasm, that is nothing but a cytoplasm. First protoplasm will fuse, that step is called as the plasmogamy. So two gametes should be there, between two gametes. So N plus N cytoplasm, that is called as plasmogamy. Next comes the karyogamy. It is a fusion of two nuclei. As I told, inside the gamete protoplasm will be there, and in the center nucleus will be there. When protoplasm fuses, plasmogamy. Now the nucleus fuses, the fusion of nuclei. When the nucleus of these two gametes will fuse, then that step is called as the karyogamy. Fusion of protoplasm, plasmogamy. Fusion of nucleus, karyogamy. So two steps over. Then when the protoplasm and nucleus fuses together, what it forms? It forms the zygote. Clear? Now the zygote is formed. After formation of the zygote, the third step will start, that is the meiosis. So meiosis occurs in zygote. So already the zygote is formed. So now meiosis, it will start in this zygote. After the meiosis, what happens? It results into the haploid spores. It results into the haploid spore. So now, before undergoing the meiosis, the karyogamy has taken place. So when the karyogamy takes place, zygote is formed. So zygote is what? Zygote is diploid in nature, because two set of chromosome is there, one N and another N. So when these two fuses, what they produce? The diploid, 2N. Okay, so zygote is diploid. So when it undergoes the meiosis, it will undergo the division. So again, diploid is divided into the haploid. So 2N, it becomes N and N. So when one set of chromosome is present, N, it is called as haploid. When 2 is present, then it is called as a diploid. So when it undergoes the meiosis, diploid, when it undergoes the meiosis, it produces the haploid spores. Then what happens? These spores, they will germinate, they produce the hyphae, and again they produce the new individual. Clear? New individual, again it produces the two gametes. Then these two gametes, first the cytoplasm fuses, that is plasmogamy, then nucleus fuses, that is karyogamy, then it produces the diploid zygote. Zygote will undergo the meiosis and it produces the haploid spores. Clear? So this is the sexual reproduction. Plasmogamy, karyogamy and meiosis. Clear? So here you can see in detail. In sexual reproduction, two haploid hyphae come together and fuse. So here you can see, this is the fungi. Okay, basidiomycetes. So here this is the fungi, and here the two haploid hyphae, this is, here you can see plus, and here you can, this is minus. So mating type. So this is one hyphae, this is another hyphae. Or gamete, male gamete or female gamete. You can take for example male and female gamete. So here what happens? They fuse together. They fuse together. First what fuses? The protoplasm fuses. So that step is called as plasmogamy. Then after that, in some fungi, fusion of two haploid cells immediately form diploid cells. Immediately they form the diploid cells. So here you can see dikaryotic mycelium. In other fungi, here you can see the dikaryotic stage, means protoplasm is fused, so plasmogamy. When the protoplasm fuses, the two nucleuses will be there in that hyphae. So N plus N, two nucleuses will be there. So that stage is called as dikaryotic stage or dikaryophase. That stage is called as dikaryotic stage or dikaryophase. That is two nuclei per cell. In one cell, two nuclei is present. So that stage is called as dikaryotic cell. Such a condition is called as dikaryon. That stage is called as dikaryophase and that condition is called as dikaryon. Later, the parental nuclei fuse and the cell becomes diploid. So as I told in the previous slide, the two nucleuses, they will fuse. So plasmogamy, after that karyogamy. When two nucleuses fuse, they become the diploid, the 2N, two nucleus will be there. So dikaryotic fuses and then it will become the diploid in nature, 2N. So here you can see the two nucleuses are there in each cell. So this is called as dikaryotic stage, two nucleuses. Then these two nuclei, they fuses. These two nuclei, they fuses. Here you can see they have become one nucleus. So it is called as diploid now, fused nucleus. So after the fusion of nucleus, it enters the third stage, that is meiosis. So plasmogamy over, then the karyogamy over here, fusion of nucleus, and third now it enters the meiosis. So when it enters the meiosis, it undergoes the division and finally again it forms the haploid spores, that is plus and minus, that is male and female. So again they will fuse, plasmogamy, karyogamy, meiosis. So this continues the sexual cycle. So this is the sexual reproduction in the fungi. The fungi form fruiting bodies in which reduction division occurs, leading to the formation of haploid spore. So whatever this meiosis is occurring, it will occur into the fruiting body. So fruiting body leading to the formation of haploid spore. So here only the diploid is converted into the haploid spore. So in the agaricus, you can see from this umbrella-like structure up to this straight stalk-like structure, this is called as the fruiting body. So this is about the reproduction in the fungi. Now, the classification. So on what basis the fungi are classified? Based on the morphology of the mycelium, what is the structure of the mycelium, then mode of the spore formation, how the spores are formed, and fruiting bodies, mode of spore formation and fruiting bodies. The fungi are classified into various classes. So morphology of mycelium, mode of spore formation and fruiting bodies, depending on this, these are classified. So here you can see the kingdom fungi, it is classified. So, as I told, these points have been taken into consideration. Before that, the reproduction is taken into consideration. Sexual reproduction, not known, and sexual reproduction, known. Means here the sexual reproduction is occurring and here the sexual reproduction is totally absent. So, you know that in the fungi, vegetative reproduction, asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction, three types are there. So in some fungi, the sexual reproduction is not seen. So that is one group and that is called as the fungi imperfecti. Fungi imperfecti means what? They are not perfect because sexual reproduction is absent. So fungi imperfecti, or it is also called as the deuteromycetes. It is also called as the deuteromycetes. So this is the one group. So this will study in the last. This will study in last. So understood here, sexual reproduction is not seen. So it is called as fungi imperfecti or deuteromycetes. So this is one group. Now, the fungi in which the sexual reproduction known. The fungi in which the sexual reproduction is occurring. Then, next point is taken into consideration, that is the mycelium. As I told, morphology of the mycelium. So mycelium is aseptate and mycelium is septate. Aseptate means what? They are forming a tube-like structure. The wall is not there. The septa is not there. And here the mycelium is septate. The wall is there. And they are forming the septum. So mycelium is aseptate. When the mycelium is aseptate, Here you will call them as the lower fungi, or it is also called as the phycomycetes. So here deuteromycetes. So now in sexual reproduction, first type we are studying, that is the mycelium is aseptate, that is called as phycomycetes or lower fungi. Okay, in this again, the lower fungi. Then the higher fungi. Higher fungi means what here? You can see the mycelium is septate. If the mycelium is septate, these are called as the higher fungi. So higher fungi, again we'll find two types here, ascomycetes and basidiomycetes. Ascomycetes means though they are sac-like fungi, and the basidiomycetes means they are club fungi, sac fungi and club fungi. So here four groups we are going to study. Deuteromycetes, that we are going to study in last. So first we'll study phycomycetes, then ascomycetes and basidiomycetes. Clear? So we'll start one by one. First one, that is the phycomycetes, or it is also called as the lower fungi, because these are aseptate. Mycelium is aseptate. They occur in aquatic habitats. Where they are present in the aquatic habitat and on decaying wood in moist and damp places, or as obligate parasite on plants. They are found in water and also in the decaying wood, the wood which is decaying, in moist places or as parasite on the plants. Now all these terms you know. The mycelium is aseptate. So this is important one. The mycelium is aseptate. So aseptate, we have seen that aseptate means they are having the tube-like structure, and in that tube-like structure the cytoplasm will be there, and in that cytoplasm many nucleases are there. So that is called as what? Cenocytic. So cenocytic mycelium is there. Aseptate and cenocytic mycelium. So for example, the mucor rhizopus, that is the bread mold. On the bread you will find the black color fungi. Okay, so this is the rhizopus. Actually this is this color, when it is kept for many days, will appear in black in color. So rhizopus on the bread, this is one example. Next, the albugo. Here this is the parasitic fungi on the mustard means mori. On the leaf of the mustard you will find this fungi. This is sucking the nutrition from the leaf of the mustard. So this is the example, that is albugo. Clear? So these are the phycomycetes. Example, the rhizopus. This is rhizopus, mucor rhizopus. And second one, that is albugo. These are the phycomycetes example. Then the reproduction. So phycomycetes, they are having the sexual reproduction. So sexual and sexual both are there. So first, asexual reproduction. It takes place by the zoospores are there. Zoospores are motile. And one more, that is by aplanospore. Aplanospore, these are non-motile. Motile means what? Moving. Non-motile means not moving. So moving, these are called as the zoospores. And these are produced in sporangium. So here you can see this is the sporangium, a sac-like structure is there. This is sporangium, and in this sporangium you will find what are produced. These are the zoospores are there. So these zoospores are motile. So here you can see the flagellum is there. So with the help of this flagella they are moving. So these are motile zoospores. So from this sporangium these are released, and wherever they will get the favorable condition, there they will start germinating and they form the new organism, that is the phycomycetes. So this is asexual reproduction. Now the sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction occurs by the zygospores. The zygospores are formed by fusion of two gametes. So as I told, the sexual reproduction involves plasmogamy, karyogamy and meiosis. So first the two spores are formed, plus and minus. Then this plus and minus hyphae, whatever is there, they are fused together. Then after fusion they will form the zygote. So this is zygospore, are formed by the fusion of two gametes. So like this, the zygospore is formed, and from this zygospore, then the new organism is formed. So this is sexual reproduction. So these gametes are isogametes or anisogamous. So what are these plus minus? Are there or oogamous? Plus minus is there. These are isogamous or anisogamous or oogamous. Isogamous means what? Similar. Both the spores are there. These are similar in size. Both are similar in size. Then it is called as the isogamous. Iso means same. Anisogamous, or it is also called as oogamous. Anisogamous means these are dissimilar. One is bigger one, another is smaller one. That is called as anisogamous or oogamous, dissimilar. So here the spores are isogamous or anisogamous. But the steps whatever are there are similar. Two are there. They will fuse together to form the zygote. That is called as a zygospore, and then it will develop into the new organism. Then this organism again it produces the spores. Again they will fuse and they will form the new organism. So that is sexual reproduction. That finishes the phycomycetes. Then the second type, that is the ascomycetes, that is sac fungi. As I told, depending on the what type sac this is called as a sac fungi. So these are unicellular, for example the yeast, it is unicellular, or these are also multicellular, for example the penicillium. We have seen both the structure, yeast and penicillium. So both are there, unicellular and multicellular. They are saprophytic, decomposers, parasitic or coprophilous fungi. Saprophytic means growing on the dead decayed material. Decomposers means they are decaying that dead organisms. And parasitic means living on the other organisms. Or coprophilous. Coprophilous. This is one more question. What are coprophilous? Coprophilous means what? They are growing on the dung. That is the digestive waste of the cows and the buffaloes. Dung. So in that dung, these are living. So these are coprophilous. So here the mycelium is branched. Okay. First we have studied first type, that is phycomycetes. These are aseptate, but here the mycelium is branched. You can see the branching like mycelium and septate. Septate means you will find the septa, that is cross wall is there. So here you can see the branch. So here these are the branches you can see. Okay, so branches. So it is called as branched, and septa is also there. This septa or the cross wall, it is separating the fragments. Clear? So this is penicillium example, or the first that we have seen, this is the yeast. Both comes under the ascomycetes. So here asexual reproduction in the ascomycetes, it occurs by the conidia. In one of the side we have studied the life cycle, that is conidia are produced exogenously, means outer. On the top of this the conidia are produced on the special mycelium called as the conidiophore. So this structure is called as conidiophore, and on this conidiophore the conidia, that is spores, are produced. Conidia germinate to produce the mycelium. So this will germinate whenever they will get the favorable condition, and it produces the mycelium and new organism. Then sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction, it occurs by ascospores. It produced by ascospores. These are produced endogenously. So here in the previous slide, asexual reproduction, these are produced the exogenously. Exogenously means what? Outer side. But here in the sexual reproduction, these are produced endogenously. Endogenously means inside. Where inside? In the sac-like structure, that is called as the asci. So only these are called as the sac fungi. So singular word is called as the ascus. So asci are arranged to form the ascocarp. Asci are arranged to form the ascocarp, that is called as the fruiting body. For example, the aspergillus, claviceps and neurospora. So neurospora is used in biochemical and genetic work. So neurospora, whatever this fungus is there, it is used in the biochemical researches and the genetical work. Here you can see the ascocarp. This is the ascospores are there. These are the ascospores, and where these are produced? These are produced endogenously inside the sac-like structure. This is called as the ascocarp. In this ascocarp, these ascospores are produced. Clear? So many members of these ascomycetes, like the morels and the buffles, are edible and are delicacies. Edible means what? These are eatable. These are used as the food material. So this is the sexual reproduction. The spores are produced, and the cycle, you know, spores are produced plus minus. Then they undergo the plasmogamy. They will undergo the karyogamy. They will undergo the meiosis, and again the new organism is formed and they produce the spores. So that is sexual cycle, wherever it is repeated. So this example, in the previous slide we have seen, which is this is Aspergillus, the first Aspergillus, the sac-like structure. Then the claviceps, this is the claviceps. Here you can see this is the fruiting body, sac-like structure. Inside that the spores are produced. Then the neurospora. Here also you can see the sac-like structure, and inside that green color dot you can see those are nothing but the spores are there. So this neurospora, where it is used? One mark question. Is used in biochemical and genetic world, that is neurospora. So this is about the third one, that is the which we have studied, ascomycetes. Second one, phycomycetes. Ascomycetes is completed. Now the third one, that is basidiomycetes. It includes mushrooms. Here you can see mushrooms, basket fungi. This must you must have seen on the big trees. And the puff balls. Here, this also you must have been observed in the wet soil or the where the moisture is there. So basidiomycetes, they occur. They include the mushroom, the basket fungi, and the puff balls. They grow in the soil on logs and tree stumps, and in living plant bodies as parasites, for example, rust and smuts. So on the living plant body, they are living. This is the basket fungi. Mycelium is branched and septate. If you see the mycelium, it is branched. In the mushroom, you must have been seen the branched mycelium is there, septa is there. The asexual spores are generally not found. The asexual spores are generally not found, but vegetative propagation or vegetative reproduction by fragmentation is occurred. By fragmentation means what? If you cut this organism into many pieces and put it into the soil, they will grow into the new organism. If you cut this and put it into the soil, they will grow into the new organism, fragmentation. So asexual reproduction is usually absent, but vegetative and asexual reproduction is present here, that is basidiomycetes. So this is these are the examples of the basidiomycetes. The agaricus, that is mushroom. Here you can see agaricus. Then the Astilago, here this is the example, and the Puccinia, that is rust fungi, Puccinia on the leaves of the mustard. So this comes under the basidiomycetes. So here the sex organs are absent, but the plasmogamy occurs by fusion of two vegetative or somatic cells of different strains or genotypes. The resultant structure is dikaryotic and it gives rise to basidium. Here the different sex organs are absent, but the plasmogamy, it occurs by the fusion of the protoplast, that is called as plasmogamy. It occurs by the fusion of two somatic cells. Somatic cells, these are the vegetative cells. Okay, but they have the different strains or different genotypes, different genes are there. The asexual or vegetative cells only, but they have the different strains and they are going to fuse here, and they result into the dikaryotic. Dikaryotic means what? First the protoplasm will fuse, and then the nucleus will, the protoplasm is having the two nucleuses. So it is called as dikaryotic, and it gives rise to the basidium. So karyogamy, that is fusion of nucleus, and meiosis occurs in basidium, producing four basidiospores exogenously. So this is the basidium, the fruiting body. So the karyogamy and meiosis occurs here, and it produces four basidiospores exogenously. Exogenously means outside only you will find the spores are produced. The basidia is arranged in fruiting bodies called basidiocarp. in these fruiting bodies. If you see the mushroom internally, you will find the line like gills like structure. So that is called as the basidiospores. That is called as a basidium, and in that basidium the basidiospores are produced. So basidia are arranged in fruiting bodies called basidiocarp. Here the fruiting bodies present inside this umbrella like structure is called as the basidiocarp. So just you remember here the sex organs are absent, but the fusion of vegetative or somatic cell occurs plasmogamy occurs in them. Then they form the basidium. Basidium, it is followed by the karyogamy and meiosis and produces the basidiospores. Where the basidiospores are produced? In the basidiocarp. For example, the agaricus is there, ostilago is there, and puccinia is there. And the last one, that is the deuteromycetes. Deuteromycetes, these are commonly called as the imperfect fungi. Why it is called as the imperfect fungi? Because only their asexual or vegetative phases are known. The sexual reproduction is absent. So it is called as imperfect fungi. Sexual reproduction is absent. When perfect stage were discovered, they often move to ascomycetes and basidiomycetes. If the sexual cycle is present in them, sexual reproduction, then they are also moved to the ascomycetes and basidiomycetes. But the sexual cycle is absent, so they are called as imperfect fungi. It is also possible that the asexual and vegetative stage have been given one name and the sexual stage another. When the linkage were established, the fungi were correctly identified and moved out to the deuteromycetes. So this is not much important. So just you remember that deuteromycetes are known as the imperfect fungi. Why? Because only you will find the asexual and vegetative reproduction. The sexual reproduction is absent in them. So these are called as the imperfect fungi. So what are the examples for the deuteromycetes? Deuteromycetes reproduce only by asexual spore, that is the conidia. Clear? So here the mycelium is septate and branched. Okay, the some are saprophytes or parasites. Majority are decomposers of litter and help in the mineral cycling. Decomposes means what? They are decomposing the dead plants, dead leaves or the branches of the plants and helping in the mineral cycling. Mineral cycling means what? Whatever the minerals are there in that plant and animal, they are decomposing and giving it back to the soil. Then from the soil again they are taking inside the plants. So that is recycling. What are the examples of deuteromycetes? Alternaria, this is the alternaria. Then coleoptrichum, this is coleoptrichum, and trichoderma, this is trichoderma. These are the three examples of deuteromycetes. These are not perfect fungi because sexual reproduction is absent in them. Only they reproduce by the asexual spores called as the conidia. So conidia are produced and they are germinating and they are producing the colony. For example, alternaria, coleoptrichum and trichoderma. So these are the three examples of deuteromycetes. So in today's class we have studied kingdom fungi in detail and the classification of the kingdom fungi. So which is the first one? Under the kingdom fungi, which is the first class, that is phycomycetes, also called as the lower fungi. Second one, that is the ascomycetes, it is also called as the sac fungi. Then basidiomycetes, and last one deuteromycetes. Deuteromycetes is called as the imperfect fungi. Clear? Okay. So this finishes kingdom fungi. In our next lecture, we are going to study about kingdom plantae, and that will be the last lecture on this chapter number 2. Thank you, my dear students, and this lecture will be followed by the notes. So write down those notes in your fair notebook. After that, chapter number 1. So I hope that you are watching the video and also writing down the notes correctly along with the diagrams. Thank you.